by knocking off defending champion BYU 27-24. It was Matt Stevens off the bench in relief of passes this year. Gaston Green, the leading rusher and a good one. And Melfar Jr., another running back. The wide receivers, they're fleet and they've all capable of getting the long ball. Mike Sherrod, the all-time record holder. Kyle Durrell caught two touchdowns, the last Rose Bowl, and Derek Tennell is the tight end. Stevens to throw on his first play as a man open. It's fine. McCullough, his 33rd consecutive start, weighs 262. Goble at 260 pounds at center. Mike Hartmeyer, all packed in at 265. And the left tackle is Robert Cox, a little guy, 258. They'll measure for the first down. Tom Quinn, a Big Ten official, with the honor today. He in the white hat, and it's that far shy of a first down. 1 Coyne, Neese, Gallagher, Sherlock, Dorkowski, Armstead, Stewart, the men honored from the Big Ten and Pac-10, and indeed it's all of that. We talked to them yesterday, and they're as thrilled as the players.
Their eyes were bright and shining, weren't they? Just short of that first down, they measured it, and they'll take the six back to the sideline. Interesting that UCLA would start with a pass. We expect them to rely most heavily on the running game today. It's really been the strength of their offensive football during this season.
His fifth start is his biggest. A man recruited Hayden Fry. He wanted him at Iowa, but Stevens said he did not want to leave Southern California. And he has the first down, wedging straight ahead to the 41-yard line. The Hawkeyes defensively. And this is a good defensive team in the top five in the nation. Bruce Geer at one end. They have a five-man front. John Brees and Iowa star, the Freeman in the middle of the line. Hap Peterson, an all-Big Ten nose guard. Jeff Gross is their best pass rusher, 9 sacks this year. Richard Pryor, no relation to the comedian, is at left end. In fact, he doesn't even talk. First down from the 41. Play action in trouble, Stevens, but he's able to get away from Gross, but not able to elude John Brees, the right tackle. As Brees, a junior from Forest City, Iowa, has the sack. The rest of the Iowa defense, there's an All-American number 36, Larry Station from Omaha, Nebraska, and George Davis, tough from Des Moines. We'll check the back four for Iowa in a moment. It is second down and 16. From Gaston Green. The exchange was not a healthy one, and that was to be expected.
That's something that can happen when you have a quarterback who hasn't had that many snaps during a lot of parties.
The defensive backfield for the Hawkeyes. Let's meet them. Nate Greer at the right corner from Brooklyn, New York. Devon Mitchell from the same high school in Brooklyn. Tilden, Jay Norvell. He had 7 interceptions to lead the Big Ten. And Ken Bubba Sims at the other corner. Third down and 22 yards, makes that 23 yards to go. And nothing much on that third down effort as Farr goes up the middle. And the Hawkeyes are about to get the ball for the first down.
A little bit of strategy by Hayden Fry pays off. He put his defense out there, got a sack on Matt Stevens. They're going to get it in good field position here to put their offense on the field.
Bill Happel, number 40, is deep for the Hawkeyes. Fourth down, it goes over to Iowa. First and goal.
see where everyone was and lost the ball. It rolled in behind him. The Hawkeyes are just outside the 5-yard line.
Chuck Long, the All-American quarterback, to Ronnie Hart. He fumbles, and UCLA has it. Oh, my. The ball is dead. His hand was down as he caught it on the fly. Had he been on his feet, he could have advanced the fumble. UCLA's Marcus Turner gets the turnover right back to the Bruins.
Boy, you talk about a flip-flop of emotion after that big play to give themselves the ball inside the 10. There's the hit right there. Knocked that ball out of his hand. And that's Jarecki, number 99, reaching in to knock it away. And UCLA pounces on the football.
Boy, you're almost having a look at the Big Ten field. Dante, is there a jinx in Pasadena? Ooh. You couldn't have been presented with a better opportunity. First and goal at the 5, and you fumbled it away on the very first opportunity. 2.5 minutes have been played, and we've had plenty in Pasadena.
First, Iowa at the UCLA 5, only to have Harmon fumble, and the Bruins have it back at the 7. Together to Gaston Green out across the 10-yard line. Breeze trips him up for Iowa. It'll be second down and 6. Gaston Green, he's a sophomore, rushed for a big game in the Fiesta Bowl a year ago today. Remember? He had 144 yards and a couple of touchdowns. Stevens, with only 41 attempts, one start and a couple of relief roles during the course of 85. I have a feeling we'll see David Norrie, unless Stevens has an exceptional afternoon. Mel Farr Jr. That'll make Papa proud. He's here from Detroit. First down, UCLA.
Smart play by Farr. He actually used the official as a blocker as he stepped in behind the umpire. Let's get in and look at that handoff between Stevens and Farr. You know, he dropped one out of there just a moment ago.
Actually, Gaston Green.
You're right, 44. But you see how he used that official just sliding to the outside. Got an extra blocker out of the striped shirt.
Marcus Greenwood in for Mel Farr, number 45 at fullback. Stevens play action. Sidelines almost intercepted by Nate Greer. Greer, who did not have an interception during the course of the regular season.
When you have a good, solid running game, you can make a defense cut up short with a good fake. They did a good job that time of faking it into the line. We're looking from the offside of the field. Watch Stevens here with a little fake of the toss. Turns right back inside. But Nate Creer was not fooled. He had great position and almost intercepted that football.
Second and 10 from the UCLA 20. Green in motion. And they throw to Green. And he's able to manage a 4-yard effort, tripped up by Ken Sims. Jay Norvell was in on the play as well.
Norvell, the first man there, very active defensive back, and a nice story, Dick. Didn't really have much of anything going for him at Iowa until this year. Found a job, found his confidence, and has developed into an outstanding defensive back.
Fifth-year senior Norvell led the Big Ten with 7 interceptions. Third and 6, and the Hawkeyes ready to tee off on Stevens, who throws to Sherrod. First down at the 38. Mike Sherrod, and what a story he is. The all-time UCLA leader in receptions with 124. A walk-on student, missed half the year with a broken clavicle, returning from midseason to the Rose Bowl.
Here's a chance to see how Sherrod gets open. The blitz was on that play. Larry Station coming inside. Read well by the quarterback. There's Station, 36, right in the middle of your screen. He's picked up on the play. Stevens did a good job.
Good play by Stevens, but it did not fool Iowa as Gaston Green is smothered in black. Breeze and Gear on that right side, the primary hitters.
One of the things that is a trademark of this Iowa defense is what we would call stemming, the kind of jumping around that they'll be doing on the line of scrimmage, especially with those linemen and the two inside linebackers. They like to move around in there and try and mix up the offensive blocking assignment. There you see him shifting right there.
Mel Farr and Eric Ball in for the first time. Stevens intercepted by Clear. Durrell drags him down at the 33-yard line, and a flag is down.
We've got a face mask on that play that's going to add some yardage to the field position of Iowa, where, as you remember, missed a pass just moments ago. This pass goes right through Carl Durrell's hands, but it doesn't miss Nate Freer. And watch the grab right here, reaching in and taking a hold of the mat. You'll see it at the end of this play. It'll add yardage on for the Iowa Hawkeyes.
So this first quarter thus far played entirely on UCLA. So Nate Freer with the interception, and then Durrell dragging him down. They call that a 5-yard grasping the mat, not twisting him down. Could have almost gone for the 15. And the Hawkeyes have it at the 29. We haven't played 5 minutes yet, Merlin Olsen, and the ball has changed hands on turnovers 3 times.
Turning over very quickly, and Iowa missing that great opportunity down at the 5-yard line. Now with, again, excellent field position just inside the 30. They need to take advantage of this, get some points on the board. You don't want to get that many chances and blow the opportunities. That really pumps your opponent up.
Now you talk about in the NFL, a 3,000-yard season by a man playing in 16 games. Here's Chuck Long in 11 games, just 22 yards away from a 3,000-yard season. That gives you the kind of numbers that show you the impact of his performance on this Iowa successful year.
He really has an unusual throwing style that we'll try and document for you during the day.
Looks almost like a mix-up, and then Hudson is stacked up by quintet of white jersey Bruins. Jarecki and Jackson were the first two there. Hudson, a sophomore in that backfield for Iowa.
If you are a defensive player, what you want to do is be a part of that swarm. There were about 6 Bruins on top of Hudson, and he's an explosive player. He's very important to that Iowa offense. You try and gang up on the running backs back there, Ronnie Harmon, you can't do it because Hudson's popping up inside.
Against the defense, no one was better against the run in the NCAA major colleges and universities this year than UCLA. Play action to Harmon. Bruins are looking pass, and Harmon has a first down at the 18. Ducky Miller pushes him out of bounds after a 13-yard run by Harmon from Walton, New York, went to Bayside High School.
Cutting back against the grain. Now watch Harmon. He's going to come from off of your picture and start inside on this play. But it's his ability to cut back against the grain and way off to the opposite side of the field that really makes this play possible for him. Now watch him as he starts inside and now breaks back against the grain. Beautiful job.
And back to live action as it was Harmon again on the carry. Joe Gasser makes the stop for UCLA. And a good carry on first down to the 10-yard line where it'll be a second and a long 3 for the Hawkeyes. Harmon, some would argue, may be the greatest offensive player in the history of Iowa. Of course, you go back to Mal Kinnick, and that's a tough argument. But he will finish as the number 1 receiver in Iowa history, the number 2 rusher in Hawkeye history, and the number 2 scorer.
Number 2 rusher after really only being in that backfield for 2 years, was a wingback 2 years.
Hudson through the middle, and he is jolted very close to a first down, however, right at the 7-yard line. Coming up to greet him was Terry Toomey, number 40, the nose guard.
Terry Toomey, a nice story, not a big nose guard, about 235, 240 pounds, but very quick and a very intense player. You look at him and you say, oh, he's giving away a lot of size to that big Iowa offensive line, but he plays with the kind of intensity that makes him really bigger than he is.
3rd and 1 for Iowa at the UCLA 8-yard line. Big play. On the ground, it is a first down as a fullback, Hudson, falling straight ahead. Tommy Taylor, 42. Batchkoff, 92. Jarecki, 99 on the stop. But the Hawkeyes have it, 1st and goal again.
I talked to Mike Haight earlier. He said we have some size advantage. We're going to lean on them. We're going to try and wear them down. You saw it right there. They drove that smaller UCLA defensive line off the ball and picked up the first down.
It's interesting, Merlin, that Iowa with the ball thus far in the game has not attempted a pass. And they were looking for that ball in the air a lot. And so was Donahue.
Well, if you establish the running game, that makes the passing game a lot easier.
1st and goal. Hudson pushing to the 1-yard line. He's from Waxahachie, Texas, the only starting sophomore on Iowa's offense. Joe Gasser up to make the tackle, playing in place of Craig Rutledge. Rutledge, one of the better defensive backs in that secondary. They'll miss him, in particular, against the running game. He's very, very good at coming up to stop those running backs.
The H boys, Hudson and Harmon, have kept it on the ground, and now it's Hudson over the top.
To hold, and it's good.
After Nate Greer's interception, 29 yards in 7 plays. And from the camera on the far side of the field, watch Hudson, number 20. What a thrill for that young man. The sophomore able to get that ball out the goal line. It's a touchdown for Iowa, and the Hawkeyes have the early lead, 7-0, with 7:02 left in the first. A redshirt freshman, actually. He has 3 more years of eligibility, has given Iowa the early lead, 7-0. Now Rob Houtland to kick off to the Bruins. A couple of freshmen back for UCLA, Daryl Henley and Danny Thompson. It's the Henley side at the 1. And cut down on a sharp open field tackle by number 94, Bruce Gere. A starter at defensive end and on the special team. So UCLA with its third opportunity. The first two chances for the Bruins ended in a bad snap out of punt formation, and Iowa recovering at the 5 only to give it right back by way of a fumble, and then Nate Freer's interception and return to the 29 with penalty that set up the game's only score. Number 50, Hap Peterson.
Dick, did you notice how the UCLA line just froze down there? Pat Peterson jumped early. The center snapped the ball. Everyone else stayed absolutely still.
Contact by the defense. I guess.
They jump up. The officials may choose to negate that penalty if the defensive man does not touch anyone. But because of the way that was played, the ball snapped with the defensive man offside. They get the yardage.
They had contact as well, which made it a little easier for the officials. But that is a play that's worked between Joe Coble or any of the centers with a quarterback. Everyone else just freezes, and if they can catch that man in that neutral zone, or offside, even without contact, they'll take the 5, and they get it here. So now the tight end in motion. Green, not much there at all. Yes, and Green stacked up by number 36, Larry Station. That's fine, inside linebacker. An academic All-American. Right student. Wonder how things are going at Larry's food station in Omaha's north side, where Dad Sr. runs the shop and roots for son Larry. Everyone thought he'd go to Nebraska. UCLA wanted him, too.
Interesting that UCLA would have been recruiting Station while Iowa was recruiting Matt Stevens.
Both of them stayed near home. Second and 4. Darrell in motion. Sharp. His pass is offline.
About
the time before Jeff Gross applied the pressure.
Let's go back and look at a couple of defensive linemen and watch the way they're shifting around before the snap of the ball. Just turn it loose. Way to get back fired up. That was just the end of it. Actually, they had jumped around a number of times before that ball was snapped. Moving left, moving right. And what they're trying to do is confuse the blocking assignment of the offense.
We'll watch that defensive line. They'll do it throughout the course of the game. Third and 4, Stevens to throw. He's got his man Connell, the tight end, and a first down at the 36-yard line. Derek Connell, who is a highly regarded freshman and a terrific recruiting year for Perry Donahue 3 years ago. He was a fullback as a freshman, played in the 84 Rose Bowl in that position, now shifted to tight end.
He's become a very important part of the passing game, and he's an excellent blocker as well.
6'5 and 236. The jumping around as we watch the defensive line. Did you ever do that as a collegian or pro?
I did at both levels, and I hated it until I saw how much trouble it caused for the offense.
Gaston Green, small crack, but boy, that filled in a hurry as Larry Station is there. And what a sense this senior has. He has led the Hawkeyes in tackles each of his 4 years in Iowa City.
And that's not only a tribute to his ability, but also to his durability. Imagine just staying healthy enough to be in there during that many ball games. Here he is stepping up inside. 36, right-hand side of your screen, right up inside. There's nowhere to go. Station just cracking along the line with that runner.
It's second and eight.
There it is again. It's Matt Stevens doing a good job of mixing his cadence. And obviously the Iowa defense a little too eager. I think he's barking some signals.
Five ball play. Encroachment on the defense.
There was no contact that time. But this is the alertness of Goble to center to get the extra five.
Watch everyone on that line stay still. Goble sees the penetration and snaps the football. Stevens goes to his knee. Boy, that is smart football.
Hey, look,
that's disciplined football.
Talk about concrete blocks. The rest of that line, they may not get up till next Friday. They call that the freeze play. It strictly communicates.
They do freeze, too,
with center and quarterback. So the first down makes, or the five-yard penalty makes it second and three. Marcus Greenwood pushed back by the Iowa defense, and the Hawkeyes have been stingy on the ground. Gaston Green has carried six times for only 10 yards, and Marcus Greenwood got only a yard on that play. It'll be third and a long one.
The thing that is impressive to me about this Iowa defense, they started the year having graduated 9 of 11 starters. They had to rebuild this defense, and they rebuilt a good one.
It was the offense that was experienced and really gave Hayden Fry and Iowa fans their hope that did materialize of making it to the Rose Bowl. On third and short, it's Stevens. Complete to Marcus Greenwood, and a first down at the Iowa 40. The first visit by UCLA in Hawkeye territory.
This is the kind of play that Terry Donahue was most worried about. A touch pass, being able to throw that ball to the outside. We saw the end of it, but more important than the end of it was the beginning of it, which you'll see here. A little fake to the running back to give you time, and that's a pass that has to go over the hands, the outstretched hand of the linebacker. Stevens, a fine job.
Ball mark at the 41-yard line. Stevens on first down to throw. He guns that one complete at the 31. There you saw the strength of his arm as he hit Mike Gerrard. He drilled that.
Dick, you said earlier that we might see David Norrie. If Matt Stevens continues to play this way, we probably will not see Norrie. Look how he zings that ball in there, right dead between the numbers. Good arm strength. He zipped it.
Play is good for 9 yards, second and one. The score, Iowa 7, UCLA nothing, less than 4 minutes remaining in the first quarter. The sneak by Stevens, and it appears he has the first down at the 30-yard line. Matt Stevens, listed at 6'5", but that might be a little exaggeration. 191 pounds from Fountain Valley High School in Southern California. He started 3 games as a sophomore last year for the injured Steve Bono and started 1 game in the 85 season and was injured, and Norrie took over the controls and had an outstanding year. Good take.
Michigan proud of their Wolverines and proud of Eric Ball. Here's that replay. You see them popping the hole right up the middle. A good block on Hap Peterson by Goble, the center. And that's 21, Devon Mitchell, who had a chance at Eric Ball and could not pull him down. And UCLA 1 point away from tying this one up.
John Lee, the All-American place kicker out of David Clinton's hole to try to tie it. The faking again by Stevens. He really locked in the secondary. They were looking for a pass. And the draw to ball. Boy, that's the way you draw it. Just one hand on him. And we have a new game tied at 7. 3:23 left in the first quarter. Eric Ball, the freshman, with a 30-yard gallop for the touchdown. His longest of the season. He scored 7 times. UCLA well blessed at that position. Gaston Green, Eric Ball, James Primus. And now the kickoff. James Bray sends it to the goal line. Back comes Kevin Harmon, the younger brother of Ronnie Harmon, and it'll be the Hawkeyes at about their own 20-yard line. Well, we haven't seen him throw a pass as yet. Doesn't figure he'll disappoint us long. A little deception there, and outside goes Hudson for a first down. It's been a day for freshmen in this first quarter. Hudson scoring for Iowa. And Eric Ball countering the first-year runner for UCLA.
Let's go back and take a quick peek at that last play from the end zone. Chance to watch the faking by Chuck Long. And look how quickly Kelly O'Brien, 66, out there from his left guard position. You get an idea of how much power David Hudson has as he runs right out of a tackle there by Joe Gasser.
14 yards for Hudson and a first down. And here's Long's first pass in the Rose Bowl, and he finds Bill Happel at the 43, and it appears to be another first down. Dennis Price, the tackler. Bill Happel, if that name sounds familiar, a long-time Rose Bowl fan, whose daddy played here and scored a touchdown.
Chuck Long getting that ball off very quickly, and one of the things you've got to like about Happel and Helverson, the other receiver on the other side, these guys have glue on their hands. Boy, you get the ball close by, and they got their mitts on it, and they don't give it up.
That doesn't matter what the weather is. They played in rain and bad weather most of the year at Iowa, and these guys don't drop the ball.
Marker, we couldn't tell on that play. The UCLA players bouncing quickly in the air saying we've got it, and indeed Terry Donahue's Bruins have a first and 10.
Ball at the Iowa just inside the 45-yard line. 7-7 the score, 2:45 left in the first. Matt Stevens under pressure, incomplete, trying to find his tight end Cannell. Good pressure from 76, the all-Big Ten tackle Jeff Drott.
Jeff Drott all over Stevens on that play, and this is one of the things you mentioned earlier, Dick. Stevens probably about 5'10", maybe even shorter than that. Look how he has to look up over the top of that big defensive lineman. Well, he really got to look up now. He's flat on his back.
Yeah, you can tell what kind of toothpaste they use in the morning when you get that close. Second and 10. Again, it's a Gaston Green. Down to the 37 of the Hawkeyes before Ken Sims, number 9 at the left corner, can make the stop. Bubba Sims from East St. Louis, Illinois. He's the senior. Third down and 4 for UCLA. Farr and Green split now instead of the eye behind Stevens. Looking for Durrell. He's open. It's a first down at the Hawkeye 25. Harold Durrell, he led UCLA on the season with 36 catches.
Carl Durrell, who had one go through his hands for an interception shortly ago, or a little while ago, doesn't let this one get away. Just a simple little out pattern. Nobody in the picture. That's Nate Creer. 29, finally getting over there, but giving Durrell way too much room on that play.
UCLA with a first down at the 25. That's in John Lee's field goal range, but they're looking for more with 2 minutes left in the first quarter.
Green hit hard. Jeff Gross, 286-pound senior, the biggest Hawkeye, and he gets off the ball in a hurry. Gross driving to the inside on that play. Stunning, which this line does quite often. You'll see him coming from the right-hand side. He just nailed Gaston Green, who was looking the other direction. Green is lucky that ball didn't bounce out of his hands.
One of four starters on defense from the state of Iowa. The middle three, Frost, Peterson, and Vries, all from the Hawkeye State. Stevenson
looking deep for Purnell, and it's too far.
Derek Connell, the tight end. George Davis, 37, the linebacker, hurried Stevens.
Jay Norvell doing a good job of coverage, and I think Stevens wisely just decided to put that one in the sand.
Five in the quarter.
Going for six.
It was Sherrard. He was open, the pass too tall, and almost intercepted by Devon Mitchell. And here comes the All-American John Lee, Korean-born. He was on the Korean National Little League Baseball team as a pitcher first baseman. His family moving to the United States, and just recently, a month and a half ago, became an American citizen, as you heard Bill McAtee's report in our preview. Lee, on the year, missed only three field goals. He is the all-time NCAA record holder, 79 field goals in his four-year career. This one is from 42 yards. And it is good. John Lee gives UCLA the lead, 10-7. Lead for the first time, 10-7, and Lee has been a weapon for four straight years for Terry Donahue. You wonder what a young man thinks about. They all have their rituals. John Lee, well, he's a different sort of character.
I think of something really off the wall, things like being a Korean and everything, maybe what I could do something, 1988 Olympics and things like that. So maybe the NBC has a right to the Olympics, maybe do something, be a translator or something, things like that. Something off the wall. I don't really get involved with the emotional, the outcome. It's not that big a deal. It's only a field goal.
Oh, yeah. Yeah. He is cool. He is cool.
The kickoff, not by Lee, but by Bray. Down to Harmon at the five. He has some opening, 30, and tripped up at the 31-yard line, just as you saw daylight by Kirk Alexander. He is the younger brother of a former UCLA All-American, Kermit Alexander. There's Kevin Harmon. He's a year behind his brother Ronnie, playing the same halfback position.
A lot of brothers on this Iowa team. I think that's certainly a good sign for Hayden Fry's program. If the program's not going well, you don't say, hey, little brother, come on down and join me.
They like Kevin as well. He, in limited duty, rushed for 180 yards. But it's Hudson and Ronnie Harmon who are behind Chuck Long. The Hawkeyes down by three with 106 left in the first quarter. And Long's trying to open it up with protection. Good pass by Ronnie Harmon.
With a fumble in college ball unless it's caught in the air. It's UCLA and the turnover again. And who could have dreamed that your All-American running back, and you see Hayden Fry saying, hey, that's all right, we'll have our chances, stepping over there. That's three times today that Ronnie Harmon has turned the football over. He's an outstanding receiver, an outstanding runner, does not have a history as a fumbler, but boy, he's getting that ball stripped away. That's Ken Norton, 41, knocking it out of his hands right on the sideline.
In this first quarter, five turnovers, three times coughed up by Iowa, and twice by UCLA. And the Bruins have it at the Hawkeye 34.
far, and Green behind Stevens. It's Gaston Green. And like Ronnie Harmon of Iowa, boy, that wonderful ability to be able to stop and start on a dime and those quick cuts. Many feel here on the West Coast that this man, Gaston Green, if he stays healthy, is a candidate for a Heisman a year or two away. He has that kind of talent.
Certainly has explosive ability, Dick. It's exciting to watch a young man who can just leave people laying on the ground out there.
Second down, five. Look at that defense move around. Give the Green. He's shy of the first down. George Davis made the tackle. Third and short for UCLA. Probably the last play of this first quarter. 3 seconds, 2-1, and that's it. First period is history here in Pasadena in this 72nd Rose Bowl game. Turnover plague first 15 minutes, UCLA by 3. Stuart Canberg with Merlin Olsen. We go to the second quarter, 10-7 UCLA.
Dick, let's look quickly at this stemming we talked about. Bruce Geer on the top and Larry Station. Now watch how they move. As soon as Matt Stevens turns his head to call his audible, they'll move in, they'll change the look. Watch them as they shift back and forth. Very disconcerting to a defense, or to an offense.
First play of the second period is third and two, UCLA at the Hawkeye 27. They'll make that the 26-yard line. Green, big hole. 17 of Iowa. Devon Mitchell at free safety stopped the touchdown.
What a great move by Mitchell. We'll see that after we look at these stats quickly. And of course, UCLA, 102 total yards and 11:03 possession time. Boy, they have dominated the stats. Only have a 3-point edge on the board. Watch the cutback. The little wiggle right there and then the shot up inside. That's the quickness you were talking about earlier, Dick.
33 yards now for Green. First down, UCLA leading 10-7. Green up the middle, a huge ball. And he trips up and falls at the 9-yard line. That is going to be very near another first down.
Right between a couple of all Big Ten performers, Dross and Hap Peterson, number 76 and 50. It's explosiveness here that gets him through there. Watch him on the right-hand side of your screen. Right in between those two linemen. He gets away. Dross got one of those big arms on him, and that's what put him on the ground. But he picked up about 8 yards in the fall.
No doubt of the color of this drive. It's been all Green. Four straight carries by Gaston. And a second down and a long one. Green again. And a first down at the 4. And boy, that quick movement. Setting up his blockers. They thought he was going outside. But this has been a problem with Green. He has suffered injuries in his first 2 years at UCLA. He's not been 100% for either of his 2 years in Westwood.
Reaching for the hamstring there. Perhaps hurt himself as he explodes on this play. Iowa thought that one of the linemen moved prior to the snap, and they were waving that at the officials. No one made the call. Looks like he didn't get hit. I think he may have just stretched that hamstring on his own. We have an Iowa player on the ground as well. Trainer out to check on it.
Walker at 4-yard line. Greenwood and ball behind Stevens. Stevens. Fumble. That's a free ball. And Iowa has it. Cornerback Ken Sims.
Bill Brazier's defense with all the pressure on them, their feet almost in the end zone. They come wide open. Sims from the backside, and Stevens never did see him. Knocked that ball away. Norvell, two defensive backs on the blitz, and it's Norvell who covered the football to give the ball back to the Iowa Hawkeyes.
The sixth turnover today. 1986 Rose Bowl, brought to you by John Hancock Financial Services, meeting today's needs with a range of financial products. And Iowa has it at the Hawkeye 19. It remains 10-7 UCLA. 13 and a half minutes remaining in the first half. Quick hitter by Hudson. And they're using that play often. Bruins draft geared for Ronnie Harmon or the passing of Long, and it has been Hudson, the busy man in the Iowa offense.
Harmon today.
Iowa has a speed receiver in, but the give is to Harmon, and he's stacked up at the 25-yard line. Quinn Early and Robert Smith are the two burners, wide receivers for Iowa, where Happel and Helverson, the starters, are the possession men. When you see Smith and Early in there, someone's going deep.
Overcast, settling in. Not a typical California day unless you live at the beach, but it is foggy.
Third and four. Long. That quick release, and what a throw. 40, 42. Ronnie Harmon. Boy, he reminds me that quick release and throwing off the back foot of Dan Marino. Boy, does he have a quick gun.
He has a quick throwing action, and he reads the defense and the field well. Watch it as he gets great protection from that offensive line. Kelly O'Brien over there doing a good job on Whalen. And there are those soft hands. They've been a little too soft today. Dropped it a few times. But boy, that's a nice play.
Ken Norton Jr., the son of the former heavyweight champion on the coverage. That was good coverage. That's a perfect throwing. And here's another strike to Quinn Early, number one. He's a junior from Great Neck, New York. And long throwing strikes. Dennis Price, the tackler.
Now, how do you control an All-American defensive tackle? The most valuable player in the Pac-10, number 95, right in the middle of your screen. That's Mark Whalen. You just surround him with about four black shirts and then hang on. And where's he going to go?
He thought he was in the wrong huddle there for a while. Ball at the 49 of Iowa. We're at second and three. Give it to Harmon. Gets outside. Good move. And a first down at the UCLA 44. Screen, Harmon, 40, 35. And close to another first down at the 34 before Miller can get him out of bounds.
Bo Schembechler called Harmon the best dodger in college football. Down right at the edge of the field. You almost feel like you're a part of the action here. And there's the screen. You let the defensive lineman in, and then you count on the good instincts and running ability of a back like Harmon to get you downfield. Nice play, good pickup. And with short yardage, let's see if Hayden Fry might not gamble on this situation on a second and less than a yard.
Well, he's going to go for the first down and gives to the fullback Hudson. He didn't need much. Backed up by the entire center of the UCLA defense, Steve Gorecki, senior from Napa, California. UCLA, big upset 20 years ago. Mel Farr was his teammate. Bruins upset Michigan State, the number one team unbeaten that year. Long has to eat it back at the 47-yard line. So the Bruins have their first sack, and Frank Batchkoff, 92, a junior from Reseda, California, San Fernando Valley lad, makes the tackle.
Dick, we're used to seeing tight ends who get down on the three-point like these linemen. Here's the tight end in an upright position, standing up. That's a Hayden Fry trademark. He's done that since his days at North Texas State. This situation, that tight end is blocking, trying to keep Melvin Jackson out of the play. Unfortunately, Long got outside, got himself in trouble, couldn't find a receiver. We'll look at that during the play. That's a very unusual trademark or signature of this Iowa Hawkeye offense.
I'd like to ask you about that. Doesn't make it tough when you have to block down on a tackle? Second and 24. Long, look at the time. Finds his man, Robert Smith, at the 32-yard line. Gain of about 16.
What a great pass by Chuck Long. You know, you watch him in practice. He throws the ball with an almost casual flick of the arm. And you're not terribly impressed until you notice that all of those passes seem to go right where they're supposed to go. Look how quickly that ball is in the air. That little sidearm and wrist action gets it right to his receiver.
Again, that receiver, Robert Smith, well covered. And Craig Rutledge, who is playing after knee surgery, has a big brace on his knee, is in at safety. Third and nine, Harmon, looked like a little shovel pass, and tripped up. A blocking tackle by Joe Gasser, 28, who came up from a safety slot.
Trying to get that ball in behind
Whalen on that right side. When you have a very good defensive lineman, they tend to get upfield quickly. And that shovel pass discourages that kind of penetration.
Well, that was a pass, just a little delay, and then almost a forward handoff, but it wasn't handed off, just tossed ahead to Harmon to the 26, short of the first down, fourth and 2.5. Rob Houtland to try a 43-yard field goal to tie. He's got the distance. No, he doesn't. It falls short in the end zone, but a flag is down, and we may have a penalty against UCLA. Roughing the kicker, and that'll give Iowa a first down.
And Houtland, bitterly disappointed at his kick, will trade his body for the first down on that one very happily. Let's go back and look at the play. Look how sharp the angle is as he comes in. Not a good job of holding that ball, but there's the knockdown right there. 42, Tommy Taylor, the man who ended up on Houtland's legs. And, of course, that Markoff will give the Iowa Hawkeyes. Well, wait a minute. What are they doing now, Dick?
You have no tip? Okay.
We're going to make sure that the ball was not tipped before they mark off the penalty. If it had been tipped, then there would be no penalty.
If they get their hands on the football, be it a punt or be it a field goal, then you don't have the call. That's the call.
Running in the kicker, 5 yards on the first down.
Ball marked down to the 21-yard line. So the Hawkeyes, instead of coming up empty on the 42-yard miss, will get the penalty on the first down.
Coming from another angle. Watch the top of your screen. There's Tommy Taylor coming in. You see how far short the kick is. And obviously no one touched that football. That was the contention of the UCLA defense.
9 minutes and 12 seconds remaining in the first half. UCLA 10, Iowa 7. Long under pressure to Happel. First down and goal just inside the 10. Miller with a defensive play and another perfect throw by All-American Chuck Long.
A nice play as Long rolls out to his right. Just a little half roll. Gets a good block by Ronnie Harmon there, but he couldn't keep. Ooh, who is that? That's
Terry Toomey.
Diving and actually threw that ball after Toomey had a hold of his ankle.
But again, right on the run.
Wow.
Happel couldn't have asked for it in a better place. First and goal. They have the full 10 yards to go. Little misdirection to Hudson, the fullback, for about 3. Faking to Harmon left and giving to Hudson back inside, and Tommy Taylor, the senior from Chattanooga, Tennessee, freight train Taylor, 2 times an all-conference performer in the Pac-10, made the hit.
You run misdirection plays most often out of respect for a defense. Taylor is one of those who reacts very quickly. Talking to the offensive coordinators for Iowa, Bill Snyder, he said, we've got to run some of those plays to make sure that we keep that defense on it.
Second and goal from the 7. Long. Incomplete. Tight end Mike Flagg at the back end of the end zone, the intended target, but Long saw him covered by James Washington and tossed it high and away. Fans are seeing an outstanding game, and here a critical play on 3rd and goal from the 7. Hudson on a draw, and that did not fool UCLA. Tommy Taylor staying home. Ken Norton, 41, was there as well.
Everything smashed up inside as the UCLA defense responded extremely well to that play.
3 out of it, much shorter. This will be a 24-yard attempt. And we have a new game. It's tied at 10. Dennis Houtland from 24 yards after the fumble recovery when Matt Stevens was hit deep in Iowa territory. And now Houtland to kick it off. Danny Thompson, Darrell Henley are deep for UCLA. Skids it down the middle, picked up by an upback. And it's Mel Farr, junior, out to the 30-yard line.
That kind of kick works much better on an artificial turf, and the Hawkeyes use that effectively all year long. That ball kicks and skids and bounces on a natural turf, kind of kills the bounce. Far able to scoop it up on the dead run, and they've got good field position to start this drive.
Matt Stevens brings them out of the huddle. He is 7 for 13 in this first half, 73 yards, one interception, and he has fumbled once. Greenwood and Eric Ball. Gaston Green has not returned since suffering a leg injury.
It's too far.
American at Westwood.
An explosion right up the middle as Farr read the blocking well. They got station 36 to overreact, and Farr just blew his way out there for a fine game. A quick look at the linebackers. There's station number 36. You saw him overreact to the
Stevens, the flanker screen. Well read as Willie Anderson is dumped for a loss by Nate Greer.
Anderson, nicknamed Flipper, speedy wide man, the fastest of the Bruins. He runs around a 4.35. The boy Greer was right on his jersey.
Flipper got flipped on that one.
Well, that's some good scouting work by the Iowa defense. They were not fooled at all by that play. A loss of a yard, second and 11 at the Hawkeye 46. Eric Ball. Out of bounds at the 40-yard line. Devon Mitchell came up from free safety. Makes a stop on Ball. Third down, 5. Oh, big hole for Ball.
The door, and Eric Ball took it all the way in.
Let me say, it's already been a happy new year for Eric Ball.
Oh,
a great start to 86. He has carried the ball 3 times, 2 touchdowns, 75 yards. Total rushing. Lee, point after, down the middle, and UCLA leads 17-10. Eric Ball on the option, catching the Iowa defense by surprise, a 40-yard touchdown.
Dick Enberg, I know that you are a young man, but tell us about Happy New Year. Tell us about your first recollections of this Rose Bowl.
I think it was 1943. UCLA, it was UCLA's first game here. Frankie Sinkwich and Charlie Trippi came here from Georgia.
I remember that. I remember that.
Bulldogs beat UCLA 9-0. Listened to an old Emerson radio out in the San Fernando Valley. That game, remember, Bob Waterfield was the UCLA quarterback. And you know, I guess it's a measure of an event that you do associate times in your life with great moments in sports. And I think for the Rose Bowl fans, they can associate with a lot of big days with this January 1st and what happened in Pasadena. Certainly the players themselves and coaches do. Bray's kick is a long one and will not be run out by Harmon of Iowa. So they'll start from the 20-yard line.
Dick, one of the interesting things, we talk about signatures and little interesting idiosyncrasies of the teams. The UCLA kickoff team puts a couple of people way back behind the line, and they run their people up. See them coming from 10 yards back. That's Dameron and Alan Dial. Jeff Dameron and Alan Dial, look at them now. They time it so that they arrive at running at full speed. That puts two people down there very quickly into the coverage. Just a little difference there. Not many teams do that. That's something that UCLA has developed that they really enjoy using.
UCLA terminology, they call them DHs, designated hitters. Boy, that's really getting a flying start. They're starting back at the 25-yard line. Iowa now trailing 17-10. It's Harmon, and he's caught for a loss at the 18. The man who made the tackle was Ken Norton Jr. There's the comparison today, the All-American Long. He's 9 for 10, 93 yards. Stevens has hit about 50% of his passes. Another completion for Long as he hits Craig Clark, the backup tight end. He caught only five balls during the course of the year. Clark, a junior from Columbus Junction, Iowa, to the right. Helverson to the left. They stay on the ground, surprisingly, but it works. Is he there for the first down? It depends on where they mark it. I believe he might have made it. A 10-yard carry on the draw to Ronnie Harmon.
Well, did they mark it on the front foot or the back foot? He marks it right on both feet, and I think it's going to be enough for the first down.
It is. Well, that's a good call. Everyone looking fast, and he goes to the draw.
Well, Hayden Fry likes to cross you up. Nice play here. A little misdirection on the draw. Same kind of move we saw by Ball, starting in to his left, our right as we look at it, and getting the linebackers to react a little bit and then cutting back against the grain. Ronnie Harmon doing a good job on that play.
You saw Carnell Lake, 31, get to Harmon, but Harmon's strength dragging him forward for the first down at the 30. 4 minutes, 4 seconds left in the half. Long to scramble. And back to the line of scrimmage, that's all. Number 7, Chance Johnson in on that play. He is a freshman from Compton, California, was considered the top high school football player in Southern California as a senior in high school. Has been shifted from safety to a linebacker position.
Just a little half roll on that play, and we'll do it quickly. Watch the quarterback Long just stretch out of there. He'll get a block from his fullback. He wants to run a little bit further, but tremendous pressure on the outside kept him from getting out of there.
Brings up 2nd and 10. Good protection. Now breaks down. He has to dump it off to the tight end Flag. And Mike Flag gains 4 and draws a crowd of Bruins.
That's on the field right now. They got to believe that Long's going to throw the football.
Mass substitution. 6 new defenders in on this 3rd down 6. Draw. So Iowa crosses him up. And that's Harmon again all the way to the UCLA 49. First down.
That was impersonation by the character.
2:23 left in the half. Complete to Harmon. Fumbles. Is it in play? And who's got it? UCLA.
As he tried to gain added yardage.
You begin to wonder if maybe Ronnie Harmon isn't just too tight, maybe trying to do too much in this game. He may be trying Hayden Fry's patience at this point, too. As for Terry Donahue, he just tickled to death that his Bruins are getting some of those balls to bounce in their direction.
So Iowa driving toward a potential tying touchdown, trailing 17-10, coughs it up. UCLA ball, Ken Norton recovered at the Bruin 48. Stevens looking for more and going long, open.
81. Derek Connell, the tight end.
That's number 8, I think.
Oh, it is, Kyle Durrell. I was wondering, I didn't think Connell could run that fast. 38 yards on the play.
Carl Durrell can sure do it. Down the right sideline. It's just enough. He's working one-on-one on number 9, Ken Sims. And Sims just could not keep up. A little late getting his jump and missed that ball by just a fraction of an inch. Good play, UCLA.
Less than 2 minutes remaining first half. First down at the Iowa 14. Eric Ball to the 5-yard line. He's looking for the hat trick in the first half. Ball, the freshman, Station and Mitchell, two veterans in the Iowa defense, make the stop.
Hammering over the left side of that offensive line, right in behind Mike Hartmeyer. Good job.
And timeout has been called. 1 minute, 46 seconds left in the half.
Point conversion try. Duffy Doherty's team trying to make it 14-all, and UCLA won at 14-12.
This is 2nd down and 2 at the Hawkeye 6. Ball.
And he's having one. 3 touchdowns for Eric Ball.
For freshman Eric Ball. Hello, Ypsilanti, Michigan. is Community Eastern Michigan University, located there just outside of Ann Arbor. That part of the country celebrating. Michigan has beaten Nebraska, and now one of their homegrown starring here for UCLA.
Pat Peterson in a little early to get a tap on one of the linemen. Not enough to really make a difference, although Terry Donahue might elect, if that marches halfway to the goal line, to go for a two-pointer.
Tom Quinn's microphone obviously having some technical problems. This one's against UCLA. Well, what happens is Terry Donahue. There's David Norrie, number nine. A lot of things must be going through that young man's mind. He was a major contributor to UCLA winning the Pac-10 conference, and then the injury, and here in the big one, the Rose Bowl, as a senior, he has to give way to Matt Stevens. Lead to kick from 5 yards farther away. It would be, in essence, a 25-yard extra point try. He just has touch of his leg is as accurate as Long's arm.
Such a comfortable style as he just floats into that ball. Here's that touchdown play. And again, it's Ball's ability to start outside and watch the cut right here. Back inside, right through the grasp of George Davis, number 37, and on into the end zone.
And fumbling the ball away for the fourth time in the half, and UCLA quickly converting. Eric Ball, the freshman, with his third touchdown of the half, and UCLA opens a 24-10 lead. Here come the DHs as Bray hits it high and spins it down into the end zone. Harmon's going to take it out. Flags are down, and so is young Kevin Harmon at the 17-yard line. And I believe we have a penalty against Iowa. Chance Johnson, freshman linebacker, made the tackle. Flipping against the Hawkeyes. That'll take it half the distance to the goal line.
Let's go back quickly and look at that last play. Linebackers have got to flow with the play. Davis and Station, and watch them as they flow to the outside, but then watch what happens to Davis right at the end of this play. Gets outside and actually runs by the ball carrier. There it is, right there. Let's look at it right there. You see Ball cutting inside of Davis and driving then toward the end zone. He breaks away from that tackle, gets off another tackle, and throws himself into that end zone.
The three touchdowns in the first half puts Eric Ball only one away from the Rose Bowl touchdown record, modern record, from 1973, Sam Bam Cunningham. Most of those were the short ones over the top. He scored four times.
In fact, I think a couple of the shots we saw in our pregame were of Sam Bam putting himself into the air, launching himself, as he was.
And he was a guided missile for the Trojans.
Dick, in this kind of situation during the year, Hayden Fry occasionally has pooch kicks. In other words, just kicked it out on first down. He's not going to do it here, however.
From the 4-yard line, Harmon, a marked man, and it's been a highly disappointing and frustrating one for Harmon. A terrific player. He rushed for over 1,100 yards this year, caught 49 passes. You know, he started today only 52 yards shy of a mile offense for Iowa this year, but he's fumbled the ball away four times.
Believe me, they've really been isolated, and they've been thinking about nothing but football. Maybe they've been thinking too much football.
Long from his end zone. Whoa. Avoiding the safety, has a man open. Could not hit Robert Smith, the junior from Dallas, Texas. He's a top sprinter, perhaps the fastest man in this Iowa team. Got himself turned around, couldn't quite come up with it, but
it plays out. Chuck Long with the option to change those plays at the line of scrimmage, and he'll change 15 to 20 during a ball game.
47 seconds left in the half. Iowa needs a first down, and UCLA's going to get still another chance. Good catch by Harmon, one-handed, and then gets outside. And has the first down. What an effort. That was a big play. If he doesn't make it, UCLA calls time, and they would have had a chance to get Lee on the field for a field goal.
They would have had the punt.
You see the dodging ability here, Dick. You're absolutely right. That is a big play. You're already down. You don't want it to get any more. One hand. You see him there carrying that ball rather loosely in that hand. He is not, as we said, fumbled a great deal during the year, but he has had four on the ball today.
Timeout has been called, a chance for us to pay tribute to one of the teams participating today, UCLA. Long on first down, final minute of the half. Completes to Hudson, short yardage, and long down under pressure, Mark Whalen.
Dick, you keep your finger on the pulse of an offense by looking at what they're doing on first down and also how they're converting on third down. UCLA so far in the game averaging 7 yards.
Terry Toomey, sophomore from Tulsa, Oklahoma. That's a good story. Toomey, as you saw, wearing 40. He came to UCLA because he was watching the Rose Bowl game in 83 when UCLA beat Michigan. In the Rose Bowl as a sophomore. The end of the first half, UCLA by 2 touchdowns.
You got to believe UCLA is ecstatic at that score, and Iowa believes they're beating themselves.
And a big halftime of activity, scores, highlights when we return.
We're not like
Quinn Early, number one, and the younger brother of Ronnie Harmon, Kevin, number 28, on the near side. Here come the designated hitters, and the second half underway. To Harmon at the 1. 10, 20, and the 24-yard line. Appeared to be a good gap, but Steve Jarecki did a good job, number 99, of getting his body in the way. First 30 minutes looked this way, and that rushing number for UCLA really jumps out. You mentioned it, Merlin Olsen, with the quarterback Stevens replacing Norrie, the Bruins had to establish the run.
They were going to have to go to that running back situation, and Donahue said it in the opening, in our pregame opening. He said the best depth we have on this team is at running back. He has exploited it today. We saw Gaston Green early. He went out with a hamstring injury, which allowed Ball a chance to strut his stuff. And oh, how he has made an impact on this game.
Top 5 running backs for UCLA are all back next year. Long down the middle to Happel. And a first down. James Washington, the tackler, at the 41.
Some scores on the board right now.
There's Ronnie Harmon. Oh, he must have eyes in the back of his helmet. That man chasing him down, he made the right move blindly to elude the UCLA tackler before Joe Gasser could make the stop, a 5-yard gain. Harmon with the San Francisco 49ers after playing his college ball at Cornell. Long, second down and 5, barking out an audible. UCLA territory and close to a first down at the Bruin 48. Jim Waller, number 66, a freshman from San Jose, California, made the tackle. Here he is, 238 pounds. He was a high school hurdler.
Terry Toomey, number 40. You need to spell him periodically. Waller has been the guy.
At the first down.
He almost cracked up.
You see Waller with that protection. First down, Iowa. For the Hawkeyes to score here in this first possession, down by 2 touchdowns at the half. Long to the air. Robert Smith using that speed to get to the 10-yard line, a gain of 5. Washington and Miller with a tackle. Well, that really showing the substance. I don't think we've seen a back miss a step yet today.
It's really a substantial turf. They've had it in a month. They've fed it a couple of times, and it's green and it's real. Good footing.
Harmon. The first down and goal at the 3-yard line. Goal at the 4-yard line. Long asking the crowd to quiet. 2.5 minutes into the second half.
Look out.
Long. Incomplete to Quinn Early, number 1.
We got them off on the wrong foot when they were almost in this position at the other end of the field. Early in the ball game.
Long on the option. Has a touchdown. Of your fans.
They're
no question about that. And that's one of the great advantages of having a quarterback who is cool under pressure and who can throw that football accurately. You can come back from that big deficit.
Outland's try for point out of Vlasic's hole is right down the middle, and now it's a touchdown game.
The option play, long stretching down the sideline, sees an opening inside, and dives back inside. That's Melvin Jackson, number 59, getting the tackle, but not until it's too late. Well, neither team has yet punted the football. That'll tell you something.
They've either scored it or fumbled it or turned it over. Comes down to Henley, short at the 11. And Henley ducks through to about the 27.
Dick, you asked a question earlier about that stand-up tight end. And here he is, Flag, standing up. He's going to block on Bachkov right here. Watch how he drops down and gets himself into position. How quickly he's down. He turns Bachkov inside to help make room for Chuck Long. Critical part of that play.
So you can get down and block down on that defensive end or tackle from that position. Good play by Flag to set up Long. Now UCLA with Matt Stevens, the backup quarterback through the latter part of the year for UCLA, to the injured David Norrie. John Varese grabs Eric Ball, one of the few times they've stopped that freshman.
We didn't have to milk him.
Yeah, they love the farmers there in Iowa. They pay tribute on their helmets, and Southern California is trying to make them feel at home. Stevens on the scramble. Hey, not a bad piece of running. First down at the 41-yard line for Stevens, a 13-yard carry. Iowa will recognize those people who are having their own rough times. Stevens, good play action fake, and he's going for a bomb. It's Sherrard. Just inside the 10-yard line, a half step too long was the throw by Stevens. Second and 10 at the Bruin 41. In the third quarter, 11 minutes remaining. UCLA leading Iowa 24-17. And they're leading because of the play of this man, number 21, Eric Ball, 215-pound freshman who has three touchdowns. He ran into All-American Larry Station.
You look at the yardage, he's got 94, and on the day, Iowa's only got 68.
Third down, six. Stevens with great protection. He wanted to go to Anderson, looked around for someone else.
Yep,
you're more open than anyone. You got it. Rick Schmidt, number 11, nickelback for Iowa, made the play defensively. First down at the Hawkeye 40. Reverse to Corral. And he gets short yardage out of bounds at the 37 or 38-yard line. That didn't fool Iowa. From San Diego, California, as Hayden Fry, a distant relative of former President Lyndon Baines Johnson. He said that President Johnson's mother and my grandmother were sisters. He said reportedly they never really recognized me.
He's a Texan, though. Still wears the boots.
The tuxedo, he wears the boots. Eric Ball driving inside the 35. It'll be short of the first down by 4 yards. Larry Station with another tackle for Iowa.
A nice relationship and a very productive one for both men.
Rasher, his defensive guru, and Donahue has his offensive man. There's the first down throw, Stevens, to number 88, Al Wilson. First down, UCLA, Iowa 24. James Primus. He's a sophomore from National City, playing behind Green and Ball at that halfback position. I said they'll all be back. Green's a sophomore, Ball a freshman, Primus a sophomore, Farr's a sophomore, Greenwood a junior. Change of play at the line of scrimmage by Stevens, and then giving to the fullback Greenwood for three. Breeze and Station with a tackle.
On the Iowa sideline, there'll be two coaches signaling plays in. Jerry Alvarez and Dan McCartney. And they will call in those plays. Well, apparently it's already gone in. Either that or that's a very subtle.
troubled signal going out there.
That is a hidden signal.
They want him to hit. Better believe it.
Eric Ball. First down, UCLA at the 11-yard line.
Rick bowling offensive line, the big advantage here.
That run took Eric Ball over the 100-yard mark for the day. He's got it again for a yard pickup at the 10. 103 yards for the afternoon for Eric Ball. Still scoring on the first possession of the second half. 7 minutes remaining, third quarter. Option and Stevens right into the arms of Jeff Gross, the giant tackle. All Big Ten performer for Iowa.
Virtually the same kind of play that Chuck Long scored on just a few moments ago.
Al Wilson to the right. Sherrard to the left. It's to Sherrard. Is he inbounds? Yes, touchdown.
Fountain Valley, California, came into the game today to replace the number one quarterback, Dave Norrie, and oh, how he has done that job. Beautiful pass.
And that official had his nose right on the spot. There was only a couple of blades of grass between Sherrod's toe and the sideline, just inbounds. Lee for the point after.
Seen a punt in this game with 6:25 remaining in the third quarter.
UCLA 31, Iowa 17. A fog and haze on this January 1st in Southern California. 31-17 UCLA. The kickoff by James Bray. Kevin Harmon will not run it up.
Special places. If you ever have a chance, and I know all those here from Iowa would agree, what a day it is.
Taking the parade, the game, what a day. Maybe the best in America.
If you look at that score by quarters and see what Iowa has done to its opponents in the third and fourth quarters.
And Long to the air. That's good added protection. Oh, he's not exactly immobile himself, and it's Ronnie Harmon down the sidelines and out of bounds at the 44.
Out there, watch him here, dropping straight back. He knows he can't stay in the pocket. Still, doesn't lose his concentration, slides out. And right here, getting pressure again from the inside. He steps up, that was Glasser 58, trying to nail him down. Gets the ball to the number one receiver at Iowa over the years, and boy, Ronnie Harmon doing his best to get something going here.
That's how close it was, as Bo Jackson of Auburn nosed out Chuck Long in the closest ever Heisman balloting. He gives straight ahead to David Hudson, the fullback, out to about the 48-yard line, trying to keep that center of the Bruin defense honest.
Well, only three misses by Long. He has been everything that we had heard about. Ability, accuracy, a feel for the game.
Whoops, not this time, no chance. Seven, Chance Johnson shooting in from his linebacker slot.
We're going to take a peek at the quarterback's feet on this play. Now watch the way he goes back and sets up. You're not going to see the Chance Johnson coming. You see how he turned his back? I think that might have gotten him in trouble. That's a planned thing, but Chance Johnson right on top of him before he had a chance to set up. Now, when you can get on Long before he has a chance to set up with that quick release, you've really done something.
The fifth sack registered by UCLA today. The draw play to Harmon, that's been a big weapon all day, and he drives into UCLA territory to the 49. Won't be enough for a first down, but a big gainer.
Dennis Price, number six, the cornerback, bottom of the pile. Working on an injured Hawkeye.
Sideline, Durrell getting his hamstring stretched out a little bit.
That was the injury, by the way, to Gaston Green, as we surmised the hamstring. They say he could return.
Well, the way Eric Ball is playing, I don't know that you want to bring him back in there.
Gifford Irvine is the deep man for UCLA. And the first punt of the day by Gary Costa-Rubla is out of bounds. A disappointing kick for him. And we have a timeout after the 31-yard punt. 4:05 left in the quarter. Well, it's no laughing matter. The knee injury so terribly common in this game, and that has really protected a lot of severe, perhaps career-ending injuries. UCLA with the ball, less than 4 minutes remaining in the third quarter. 31-17 Bruins. That was Mel Farr on the carry, short yardage. His dad is here, and if we have a chance sometime during the half, we'll try to locate Mel Farr Sr., teammate of Terry Donahue. 20 years ago, and UCLA upset Michigan State in this game, and the battle for number one, Penn State and Oklahoma, ranked 1 and 2 in both polls, coming up after this Rose Bowl encounter. Stevens looking off the coverage and going to Tinnell as tight end, short of the first down, about a 5-yard pickup. Michigan State scored 31 against Iowa, and UCLA has matched that, the most given up by the Hawkeyes. Stevens on the run, has a man, overshoots him on the far sideline, Al Wilson. But Stevens was under pressure. He's a fiery guy, and one of the nice things you heard about him from Terry Donahue, he said even though he was hurt, he lost his job to David Norrie, he didn't pout about it, he didn't get his chin down. He was just as enthusiastic on the bench with his teammates as he was as a starter. And so, you know, your time comes around. First punt of the day. Ted Henderson. Had to rescue him off a mountain in the Fiesta Bowl last year. That was his claim to fame. End over end. Fair catch. Bill Happel. Iowa has it at the 38-yard line. Timeout. 2 minutes and 33 seconds remaining in the third quarter.
And Stanley's in the tailback of the tee this time. Albert right up behind the center. The ball goes back to Albert. He gives it to Gallardo. Gallardo's a 5, the 3, the 2, the 1. He's over. It's a touchdown for Stanford.
Now, brushing off a memory from the past, 1941, and Bill Stearns. Call and such clarity, that 5-4-3-2-1, Hugh Gallino, Norm Stanley, Frankie Albert, and that wonderful Stanford team that was victorious over Nebraska 21-13. It's Iowa trying to rally, two touchdowns behind UCLA, 31-17, the Hawkeyes from their 38. Long, going long, and intercepted, Dennis Price. Gulp, says Hayden. Patience.
Chuck Long has not made many bad decisions on the day. I believe he made one there. He underthrew the receiver, tried to get it to Quinn Early, number one. There were open receivers up the field, and that's what Fry was telling his quarterback, and they have almost a father-son relationship.
So UCLA on Price's intercept starts at its 21. Stevens to throw. Ooh, dangerously close to going all the way. The sideline saved Iowa as the catch made by Mike Sherrard. And the sidelines ended the play. He had nothing but green grass ahead.
Look at two things. First, the closeness of that ball, and then Sherrard's ability to get that right foot down just tightly inside the line. Almost a ballet step.
He learned that footwork from his mother, Sherry, who was a U.S. Olympic team member back in 1964, a hurdler. First down, ball. Look at the moves by this youngster. 50, out of bounds at the 44, and you're looking at the potential most valuable player in this Rose Bowl, freshman Eric Ball.
No, I don't think you have to say potential the way he's got things going for him. He is just racking this defense for the Iowa Hawkeyes. And look how quickly he spots the opening there, explodes to the outside.
Homer Smith, the offensive coordinator for this team, has just got to be so excited. He's up here calling those plays, and when they work like that, they make him look pretty darn good.
First down, ball again. Up the backs of his blockers, and a good play made by Jeff Drost and Jay Norvell, 45, coming up from the secondary.
The possibility that they may be wearing down a little bit late in the ball game.
Second down and eight. Stevens looked like his arm was hit, and he went half the throw to Mike Sherrard.
Hero, Tim Green, was the hero of that ball game for SC.
31-17, late in the third quarter, UCLA leading Iowa. Stevens, as he was hit, short hops that one, incomplete. Trying to dump it off to James Primus, still Arizona at the Fiesta Bowl, and they had to get a police helicopter up there to rescue him. He said, but he shouldn't have been fined for being out late. He was on the premises of the hotel. And he kicks it into the end zone, touchback, Iowa. Well, we're enjoying the action and the opportunity to bring it to you around the United States, but it doesn't stop there. Canadian television carrying it live. Tokyo and Japan live coverage. American Forces Radio, Italian television is live, and you see all the other countries. Suomalainen's watching there in Helsinki, in fact. Korea, 1988, John Lee. Well, we should take him with us with our Olympic crew. I wouldn't mind having him as a sidekick and an interpreter. Switzerland, Turkey, and of course, we salute. And Happy New Year, all the men and women around the world representing the United States.
I wonder if he knows where to eat over there.
That's right. Do we have time? David Hudson plowing for six or seven.
Thinking about what they're going to remember about their football experience.
And Chuck Long and company hoping to do something about it, but Ronnie Harmon, another senior, has to eat it for a loss. Iowa needs 14 to tie. The score after three, 31-17, UCLA. We'll be back after these messages from your local station. Now they're trying to win five in a row. Big Ten dominating early, and the Big Ten can't seem to buy a win here of late. Long looking for the big play. He's got it to Happel at the 44-yard line. And a first down from Kenny Plain, a great Hawkeye quarterback. Ooh. He was running out of room and time. They're going to call him for intentionally downing the ball in the grasp. Frank Batchkoff had him.
Costly penalty. They'll mark that, I think, all the way back from the spot of the foul.
That's where he would have gone down, says referee Tom Quinn. That's loss of down penalty. It's about as tough a call as you can get in the college game.
Here's the one of the defensive coordinators. UCLA employs two defensive coordinators, Tom Hayes and Bob Field. Bob Field up in the press box. Tom Hayes down on the field. He's the one in the white sweater there who sends in the calls. He handles the front seven, basically, and Bob Field handles the defensive backs. You'd think that Bob Field would be on the field instead of Tom Hayes. There you see the call going in.
Wait a minute, is this an Abbott and Costello routine?
No. There you see the calls. He's making the signals for the defense. They apparently are able to work very comfortably together.
Hawkeyes.
Get those Hawks in there somehow.
Well, a
two-point conversion to go ahead.
Second and long, the fake draw, which they've used so often. Then down the middle, almost intercepted by Steve Jarecki. Bill Happel was open 10 yards downfield, but Jarecki, 6'2 and 228. Just outside San Francisco, where Californians are so proud of their wine production. Drawn offside. We'll soon learn.
That's what they're saying, yep. Batchkoff, number 92, moved. Claimed that Mike Haight, number 79, was up.
False snap on the snapper, false snap.
Well, he's saying it was on the center. Let's see if we can see it here. Now, I believe it had happened just prior to that. It looked to me like that center did rock that football a little bit. I think it happened right as we
turned the camera on him.
So third and a long 35 for Long.
All snap offense.
Ronnie Harmon has been his favorite target. 9 catches for 100 yards today. A couple of those little shovel passes, of course, figuring in. That's Harmon in motion. They throw to him.
Double pass.
No one downfield except a couple UCLA players. James Washington was one of them.
He doesn't have any choice. I think he's coached. If the play is not there, throw it away and get rid of it. He put that one so far out of bounds that none of his teammates on the sideline could catch it. Did not fool this UCLA defense. And one of the things that Iowa is famous for is what Hayden Fry calls his exotics. This is one of them, the double pass. Well, you think that's far enough out of bounds?
That is out of bounds, even on the 14th over at the local country club.
Now, here's that strange punting formation that we've seen Iowa use occasionally. Kind of a scrubby punt. Costabula, I'll get it, Dick.
Only 10 yards back.
He kicks it from a short position, and they bring everybody in tight.
It was a dangerous fair catch and effort by Gifford Irvin. And we have a timeout with 14 and a half minutes left. A short punt, about 38 yards, so UCLA takes over at its 46. And Eric Ball, what a day for this freshman, all the way to the 40-yard line.
What's he going to do for an encore? He's already had one incredible day down in San Diego State. We mentioned that with 4 touchdowns there. He has just hammered and hammered here today. Just the dominant running back by far on the field.
He's averaged over 10 yards a carry. Stevens a fake and then a roll. Throws to Durrell coming back, and he pays for it.
Who are seniors for Iowa. Look at that difference. The Hawkeyes will graduate 17 of their starters this year. They have 3 junior starters equal in the system for a couple of years before they give them a chance to play.
Second down and a couple. Ball on his way to tie the Rose Bowl record. 4 touchdowns for Eric Ball. UCLA was offside. One of those designated hitters really got a running start. So they're going to bring this one back as Kevin Harmon stopped at the 20-yard line. Let's go back and appreciate the talents of the freshman UCLA runner again.
We have offside on the kicking team.
From ground level, you get a feeling for the power and also for the amazing speed. They call him what? The slow one?
The slow one behind Primus and Gaston Green.
I don't want to have to chase the fast ones, I'll tell you that.
Officially now, 173 yards for Ball, whose touchdown runs impressively 30 yards, 40 yards, 6 yards, and 32 yards. That's Dennis Price, who's had shoulder problems all season long, had a dislocation.
Jumped in there
saying Rose Bowl MVP, but who are you going to pick if it's not Eric Ball? Mike Flagg, the tight end, after UCLA penalized 5 yards, Steve Turek, couple Big Ten, then kind of evened up, and now it's been all West Coast in the last 2 decades. Hudson to the 33-yard line, and that'll be close to a first down, a 9-yard pickup
for UCLA to be here in this stadium.
I want you to clarify that point. It's more than just the obvious. As Long hits Happel, and Bill Happel struggling forward to the 48-yard line, and a penalty. penalty's going to be called. He was struggling, and apparently they felt that the hit was late.
Dead ball foul, personal.
Apparently the whistle had blown, even though Happel at this point was struggling forward. We can't hear the whistle, so if it's whistled dead here, then the hit by Washington is a dead ball foul.
James White with the travel and with the staying in the hotel, the disorientation of a new practice facility and so forth.
Long stepping forward, just did elude a sack by Jarecki and picks up a couple of yards down to the UCLA 37-yard line. Ronnie Harmon. Short yardage.
Dick, you look across it. And believe me, started to set a standard and gaining a kind of attention and a knowledge that has allowed him to be such a successful coach.
Long to Harmon. Ah. Oh, what a painfully long afternoon for a great player, Ronnie Harmon. Four fumbles lost in the first half and a sure touchdown dropped here in the fourth quarter.
Let's see if that ball touched any hands. It obviously was thrown well, a perfect strike by Long, who's waiting. Watch how quickly, when he decides to throw, how quickly that ball is in the air. I don't believe it touched any hands.
Like to make an excuse for Harmon, but that ball was right there.
I think he is going the kind of obvious and in the open errors that Harmon has made today. You don't sleep.
This would be a 51-yard field goal if Houndland connects. Oh, look at the length on that one. Is it good? Hits the crossbar and bounces through. Houndland, 51 yards. That's only 1 yard shy of the Rose Bowl record. Rich Spangler, 51-52. Timeout. It's 38-20 UCLA. Rob Houndland, just enough leg. And they're now saying 52 yards, officially tying the Rose Bowl record, Rich Spangler of Ohio State last year.
Aiden Frye is saying, we finally got something, and there's the onside kick.
And UCLA recovering easily, well covered by number 48, Doug Klein.
What does he tell them now? They've concentrated, they did their work, they still have lost the football game.
Meanwhile, Stevens to his tight end, Tunnell, inside the 35 to the 30 goes Tunnell. And it's not that he was going to deny them any fun. They have 2 days after the game, but boy, will it be fun now. UCLA on the march again with 10 minutes and 20 seconds left. That's Mel Farr. He is a sophomore. His younger brother, Mike, is a UCLA freshman wide receiver.
We'll try to get into the flow of this game.
Eric Ball is in the tail of that eye. He's off the blocks in a hurry, and he's so strong. Those powerful legs driving forward. Jeff Drost throwing his 286 pounds on him at the 22-yard line, where it will be third down and two.
For it, since I was 7 years old, I have never torn a muscle or strained a muscle. He has got to be heartbroken.
Here comes Ball. He's already tied a record for touchdowns with four. That'll be good enough for a first down as he goes over the 180-yard mark today. John Vries with another tackle. We've called his name often today, number 57 for Iowa from Forest City.
The one thing I think, Dick, that would keep David Norrie from feeling even worse is the fact that his substitute and his friend, Matt Stevens, has played so well today and that his team is winning. That softens a lot of blows. Another thing we might think about is what changing of the quarterback did to the emotional level and the confidence level of this Iowa team.
Eric Ball again into a crowd, out of the crowd. Well, that has separated him all afternoon. Rushing, we talked about that earlier. Charles White, our first game, Erland and myself back in 80 when White, the Heisman Award winner, he had, 71 yards of the final drive of over 80 and scored the winning touchdown.
With big men on the line of scrimmage. Wish I'd had some of those when I was playing, I'll tell you that.
Wilson in motion, first down UCLA at the Iowa 11. And this is Farr to the four. First and goal from the four. Will Ball set a record? Here's his chance. And Iowa denies at the two. Rick Ball with 190 yards. And Eric Ball looking for a tying touchdown. He has already has four touchdowns, looking for five. A Rose Bowl record. It appears UCLA wants him to get it. And there is Rose Bowl history or not. No, at the half-yard line, they mark him out of bounds. They're now put away. Watch 21 Ball. Oops, Stevens takes the sneak, and he doesn't get in. UCLA. Matt Stevens. Stevens not quite sure himself. Let's see to whom he goes. Let's follow Stevens. It's a nice story. He's paid his dues. He's rooted for David Norrie most of the year. That's a third-string quarterback, Brendan McCracken, number 12. And there is partner and quarterback David Norrie. John Lee. David Clinton holding. And UCLA with its highest point total of the year. Iowa giving up 4 points than it allowed by 10 all season long. And the question mark remains over the power of the Big Ten Conference. Year after year, they come out to the West Coast as favorites and go home well beaten. Here's that last play. Stevens just burrowing. Burrowing like a little chipmunk. He just got in there amongst those big guys and wiggled his shoulders and stuck that football over the goal line. I'll tell you this, Terry Donahue is going to be a tough act to follow. This that he has put together back-to-back.
Huh. Two Rose Bowls, a fiesta, another run
for this game today.
Gray, a busy man, will kick off again. Harmon out to the 15. And twist down at the 18-yard line. So much of the drama of this one is gone. It appears UCLA with a win, and they're getting ready in Miami.
All right, Don Cricky, Bob Trumpy, we'll look forward to your call. Chuck Long underneath the Harmon to the 19-yard line.
Ball game today.
Long down the middle, and that is the first catch of the day for Scott Helverson. There's Eric Ball. So close, within a foot of scoring a record fifth touchdown. Matt Stevens took the steak right out of his mouth there and snuck it in from 1 yard out. 191 yards for that freshman today. What a way to start a year.
As a freshman, he's got a long ways to go.
Long, good fake, throws to the tight end flag and a first down at the UCLA 46. 5 minutes and 34 seconds left. UCLA 45, Iowa 20.
You've got to feel, but it's been a sad day for them nevertheless.
Harmon, and he's in the grasp of Ken Norton Jr.
Full circle to the protection of those good old high tops. I love it.
You still wear them with your tuxedo.
Boy, and I'm talking to a man voted by Football News as one of the 10 best sports personalities of the country.
No, best dressed.
Oh, best dressed.
Best people in.
Long would like to at least get some window dressing. That's Robert Smith. Inbounds. That'll stop the clock. We'll see the all-time Iowa receiver. Kevin Harmon is in now, number 28. Smith again. Hit hard. Chucky Miller. Miller at one corner and Dennis Price at the other, both from Long Beach Poly High School teammates. Eric Ball, Chance Johnson, a couple of freshmen. Wouldn't you like to be able to eavesdrop on that conversation?
My. It's, you know, looking over at UCLA, they're just waiting to explode, too.
Long underneath. And James Washington following in the tradition at that
wrist action that he overcomes that stride.
That's Kevin Harmon.
for a first down.
He'll get that ball into the end zone.
Not all his fault, though.
No.
Here's a chance, and Bill Happel, touchdown. Yeah,
there it is.
So father and son can share the same Rose Bowl memory, both with a touchdown. Bill Sr. in a victory here in 1957.
Ducking to the outside, one-on-one coverage, Dennis Price, but that ball perfectly thrown, and he got 1 foot down.
The Helverson incomplete. Chucky Miller on the coverage, and a flag is down. And while they sort that out, let's go to the Orange Bowl in Miami and Don Crickey. They're trying to hurry this one along to get to you in Miami. UCLA penalized half the distance to the goal. It's Iowa with a second chance at a two-point play. And indeed, this a high-scoring game. Roughing the passer was the call against Long, who is on his way to the Japan Bowl after this win, where Hayden Fry will coach a team. He'll take along Larry Station, Ronnie Harmon, and Bill Happel to play for him. East-West Shrine game, Scott Helverson will play there. And it's Kevin Harmon, younger brother of Ronnie, who picks up two in the Rose Bowl. That brings the score to 45-28.
There'll be a couple of UCLA players over the
kick, and again, well covered by UCLA. The 24, Marcus Turner on the spot for the Bruins. By the way, Happel's catch was his eighth touchdown catch of the year. That's a new Iowa. Eric Ball. The kid isn't through yet, apparently. He's to the 34-yard line. He's close to 200 yards for the day. Dan Wirth and Ken Sims with a tackle. Yeah, but can they do the telestrator?
Well, I heard him say great acceleration. I knew that.
17 more yards for Ball. He has 219 unofficially for the afternoon. One of the great rushing days in Rose Bowl history, recorded by a freshman. There's Ball at 219, they say now. 247 the record by Charles White. Ball with four touchdowns, tying Sam Cunningham's modern-day record. Let's give it to someone else, says quarterback Matt Stevens. It's Marcus Greenwood, who started his collegiate career. No, that isn't. That's Danny Thompson, number 15. Thompson, a freshman from Huntington Beach High School, Southern California.
His chance, he's going to have his opportunity to at least get into this ball game.
Stevens getting a big standing ovation from the UCLA partisans across the way. And there's Norrie from Portland, Oregon. Went to Jesuit High School. Battled for 4 years on the bench and earned the starting role as a fifth-year senior. Only to miss the start in the Rose Bowl. He gets to the right man. He's been watching. Eric Ball again. Running at will through the Iowa defense. Dave Haight, the younger brother of all conference tackle. Mike Haight on the Bruins at the six-yard line. Greg Francois, or is that James Primus? It's Francois, number 33. Although it's going to be all for him. He undoubtedly will be the most valuable player. Norrie trying to get the Bruins into the 50s. With just 17 seconds left, and apparently that will be it. They'll let the final seconds tick away. Another disappointing afternoon for the Big Ten and for the Iowa Hawkeyes. And the West Coast Pacific 10, UCLA, celebrate a very impressive win, 45-28.
An outstanding performance by the Bruins. who really came out of that underdog position to hand Hayden Fry and his